helping people have better online life by ensuring the safety of their IDs.
To me, data science is using imagery to study ecosystems.
It's using advanced analytical techniques to understand how consumers interact with the world around them.
It's using invention, crime, and disease data to have a better understanding of why bigger cities are more productive and more dangerous at the same time.
Taking qualitative research, such as life story interviews, and turning it into quantitative measures.
Being able to shed light on the way patent applications are examined and eventually potentially granted.
I've been working at a finance company downtown Chicago using data science to protect people's IDs. So a typical fraud that we see is ID thefts. There are a lot of fraudsters who's trading stolen IDs over the internet. They have databases of stolen IDs and they come to us making loan applications in an automated fashion. So we, using data science, analyze their behaviors and find patterns among them to come up with rules and predictive models to make real-time decisions. In this way, we ensure that people's IDs are safe and not used for any fraudulent purposes.
I study a phenomenon that happens in the ecology of dry ecosystems. So what we're looking at in this picture is two images stacked on top of each other. One is a satellite image from 1967, and another is a satellite image that was taken more recently, within the last 10 years. These green bands are where there is new vegetation growth, and the purple is where the vegetation used to be in 1967. So this photo is showing that over time, vegetation has actually moved in the upward direction. So what's happening in this picture is that over the course of 65 years, the patterns have actually moved uphill. Using data is a way for us to actually look back in time to perhaps answer some of the same things that an experiment would.
This past summer, I was analyzing data to better understand how customers use the internet to shop. For instance, I was working with a big laundry brand, and we looked at trends in how people search for how to do laundry, or how to fold my clothes, or how do I get a grass stain out of my pants. And we could see different trends within YouTube data to understand how this brand could be better targeting their customers.
In my work, I majorly use crime data. We are interested in answering why in bigger cities people are more likely to generate new patents, more likely to commit a crime, and more susceptible to contagious disease at the same time. As cities get bigger, you are both more productive and more dangerous at the same time.
I've used data science as a way to take qualitative research and turn it into quantitative research. I read over 160 interviews. They're life story interviews. They took over a few hours to complete in person. They ranged from 30 pages to 90 pages. And then through that, we did data analysis. So you wouldn't expect psychology to be using data science, but really it is the foundation for a lot of our research. Talking with people for hours about their life story, and we hear their emotions, their background, and so kind of using data science to then take that and turn that into quantitative measures is really what data science is all about.
I do a good deal of research that focuses on innovation and information policy, patenting behavior, patent law. So there's been a lot of changes in the way people produce inventions over the past four decades and the way those inventions are examined by the patent office and whether or not the examination leads to an eventual grant of a patent. So as inventions draw on these really, really diverse areas of science, it becomes less likely that an individual examiner is going to have the necessary expertise to be able to assess whether or not this is truly a patentable invention and something we want to grant a patent for. And so by empirically demonstrating this trend, I can then make empirically informed policy suggestions about ways we may want to think about reordering the patent examination process.